said that it is a chemical method. So second important method is chemical methods. In chemical methods, there are simply two methods. Number one, colloidal method, and number two, Solger method. In colloidal method, as it word itself, colloids are formed there. Colloids, these are those nanoparticles which are having all its dimensions in particularly nanoscale. But not all the colloids are in nano structured or nano size. Maybe some are in other size, but some of the colloids are nanoparticles or nanomaterials. Now, in the particular method of colloidal nanoparticles, colloidal method, which is a chemical method to prepare nanoparticles, in this we will see that an example of chloroauric acid, that is H2AuCl4. It's a chloroauric acid. This aurium is there, and this chloroauric acid undergoes reaction of reduction. It gets reduced, and it is treated with another, that is the trisodium citrate, Na3C6H5O7, trisodium citrate. So when they treat with each other, this chloroauric acid gives this aurium, which is called as a gold, and it undergoes reduction by accepting electrons. By accepting electrons from this particular, that is the trisodium citrate, these electrons are accepted by aurium to form the same aurium of a large size. At first it was a very small size it was having, then again accepting electrons, it becomes such type of larger sized. Then again different number of electrons are accepted to form such type of very large size aurium or gold nanoparticles. And at last these nanoparticles are stabilized by such type of citrate ions. So in this way, such a nanoparticles of gold are formed by reducing number of times. So this is a particular method which is called as a colloidal method of preparing particular chemical type of chemical method to prepare nanomaterials. So this is one of the colloidal method. Now next is a Sol-gel method. In this Sol-gel method, so you may have, or I think you got this particular point. Now next is the, after this colloidal method, Sol-gel method. In this colloidal method, different examples are given, like colloids, like which is a gas in liquid. If we want to see gas in liquid, it is called as a foam. When liquid in solid, it is called as a toothpaste. When we have to see the liquid in gas, then it form. So these are nothing but the colloids. The examples, different examples of colloids which can be studied on the nanoscale. Now in Sol-gel method, sol are those substances which are found in the liquid. So whenever at first the material it is prepared in a liquid, it is called as a sol. And when that number of such type of particles, they are connected with each other, those linear connected chain form is called as a gel. So it is called as a Sol-gel method. In this Sol-gel method, first of all, a small such type of nanomaterials are prepared, which are called as a sol. And these sols are liquid filled materials, liquid filled particles. So sols are liquid filled particles. They are prepared at first, and then number of sols when connected with each other in a particular solution, then it is called as a gel. So such type of gels are formed like this. So when such type of nanomaterials are prepared, it is called as a Sol-gel method, by which these nanomaterials are prepared. Now These are the different chemical methods which are used on a very large scale. Now, next is a biological method. Third one, biological method to prepare nanomaterials. In these biological methods, there are three main methods. Number one, by using bacteria or yeast or fungus. Bacteria, yeast or fungus, by using this one, the nanomaterials are prepared. We know that generally the bacteria or yeast or fungus, they are of different types. That is, some are helpful for the human being, like preparation of curd, preparation of ghee, that is prepared by the bacteria. Then another for spoiling food, bacteria are responsible for different diseases, bacteria are responsible. So two types of bacteria are there, which are there. But in this method of preparation of nanomaterial, those bacteria which are to be used, through their cell content is directly having reaction with the metals. So any metal which is to be converted into the nanomaterial is directly, when comes in contact with those bacteria, through their cell matter, they interact with that metal and convert them into the small particulates. That is called as a method or biological method, by using bacteria converting it into the nanoparticles. We will see example after that. Then second one is by using plant extract or enzyme. Here one of the example is there, like plant which is named as a geranium plant. So this geranium plant, whenever comes in contact with a different type of, just a reaction or experiment is carried out, that simply a boiling water is considered, and in that boiling water, this geranium plant, extract of the geranium plant, that is consider the different matured leaves of geranium, and then ground them and just add them into the boiling solution. So in that boiling solution, just after a minute, you can see that the formation of a or we can say the cluster of material is there, which is nothing but the gold nanoparticles by the geranium plants when it is added, when it is treated in again chloroauric acid. So wherever chloroauric acid is there, and we have used the matured leaves of geranium plant in the ground condition, then we can get a gold nanoparticles. Then third, by which the biological method is called, by using protein and third, by using protein and or DNA template. So by like a DNA template, we can have idea about the double helix of DNA, then different chains of protein. So like that structure, nanoparticles are prepared by reacting the different ingredients, or we can say that different chemicals which are present in that DNA and proteins. There is a formation of a particular type of nanomaterials, and that is called as a biological method, by using these proteins and DNA of double helix. In this way, there are the three main types of methods by which the nanomaterials can be prepared. Thank you.